45-year-old Aris Manzouratos has lived most of his life on and around Mezogoloni Lagoon, which is 300 kilometers west of Athens. His family have been inshore fishermen for generations. Traditionally, the lagoon is opened up in the spring to allow the fish in to reproduce. Then it's closed. Come the autumn, fishing starts. But what was once a regular source of income for many families has now become threatened. Part of the reason for this has been laid at the door of the European Union.
Look at the state of my boat. It's 15 years old. I want to buy a new one, but there are too many bureaucratic hoops to go through and too many financial hurdles to leap to get access to EU funds. Probably I'd have to go through at least 50 different offices to get anywhere.
Aris is not alone. With more than 18,000 boats in the Greek fishing fleet, it's the largest in Europe, but it's only 12th in the league table of fish catches. The fleet needs modernizing, but being a new member of the EU club, the way to apply for funds is unfamiliar. Although inshore fishing is a vital part of the industry, it's clearly bearing the brunt of bad management. With more than 13,000 kilometers of coastline, Greek life without these boats and their communities is unimaginable. But the standard of living in these areas is shockingly low. Euro MP Stavros Anoutakis is alarmed. He's invited some of his colleagues to come and see the situation for themselves.
It's the first time I've seen something like this, but it would be not wise to invest money in what's really an old and outdated way of fishing. Investment would be useless and a waste of money.
Our visit is important and a reality check for many of us. Even though it's the 21st century, some people in Greece are still living in very poor conditions.
But fishermen like Sotiris Germanos would rather see results than politicians. He's worked for 40 years and says nothing's changed.
EU initiatives haven't reached here. That's probably due to our own country's bureaucracy. I don't really know who to blame. It could be a local problem. Everyone says it's so pretty here, but there's no development, no investment. That's demoralizing. But eat our fish and you can taste the difference.
So what exactly is the root of the problem? Former president of Greece's agricultural union, Ioannis Glavakis, points the finger at his own countrymen and the lack of action by its fishing unions.
18,000 boats, 35,000 fishermen, the figures speak for themselves. It's two people per boat. How do you expect these people to organize themselves? In Spain, you have 100 people working together on a boat. All these people in Greece don't have any idea about how to support each other or to apply for EU help.
So is it just a case of Greek fishermen being less able to cope than their Spanish counterparts? One thing is for certain, inshore fishing can be profitable for the larger companies which are accustomed to dealing with the EU.
On the ground, the fishermen are not getting the money. The funds are available, but it seems to be blocked at the administrative level. I'm going to write a report. I will politely point out that both the administrators and the Greek government are not working well.
The Institute of Fishing and Agriculture is grappling with the whole problem and can't understand why the EU is seeking to cut the number of boats in the fleet. Aspasia Magina is a student and complains that the government doesn't pass on information and accuses them of allowing a vital part of Greek life to be destroyed.
Δίνουν κονδύλια για να καταστραφούν βάρκες, ψαροκάικα.
Since 2001, the Greek fleet has been cut by 6.5%, but most of those cuts have come in the inshore sector. At 77, Lazaros Bakatoros, like the majority of the fishermen, has become disillusioned.
Nobody tells us our rights. Nobody explains anything. Instead, they want to destroy our way of life. But to replace it with what? Where do we go?
Low wages and living conditions, little development. Inshore fishing is crying out for modernization. But one redeeming factor, paradoxically, could be the fall in fish stocks in the wider, deeper oceans. It's meant an increase in the interest in fish farms, and the Greek coastal climate is perfect for this activity. George Bokas recognized the niche back in the early 1990s and has tapped into enthusiastic EU investment. Fish farming is growing at a rate of 5% per year. In a region which has 30% unemployment, he's created 40 jobs exporting sea bream to the European markets.
Today we produce between 80 and 100,000 tons of farmed fish in Greece. We believe that in years to come, with the help of European subsidies, we will be able to expand even more. The fish farming sector has been very dynamic over the last 15 years, and hopefully the next 15 years will be the same.
But this success does not meet with everyone's approval. Relations between the fish farmers and the inshore fishermen are not good. The latter blame the farming of fish as being responsible for a reduction in the quotas of fish needed to be caught. Greek MEPs are demanding better cooperation and recognition that Greece is a special case.
The European Union provides significant help to Greek fishermen and their families, those who live in the small islands and who are a long way from urban communities. But it is important that the Union develops a more regional approach in order to understand local problems and, for example, attract the young and women back into the industry. That will improve the incomes of all the families living on the coast.
It's hoped that the realization that help is needed won't come too late for the likes of Aris. As it stands, none of his five children want to follow in his footsteps. Aris could be the last of his family to fish in his beloved Greek lagoon.